Hey guys, this is Daniel from Manila Shaker. The Huawei P20 Lite and the Vivo V9 have been the talk of the town lately. The Vivo V9 has already been released in the Philippines, while the Huawei P20 Lite is expected to be released on April 28. Both phones seem to have some similar specs, but which smartphone actually stands out more? We'll find out soon enough. The P20 Lite opts for a modern design complete with a glass front and back, a metal frame, and curved edges. As for the Vivo V9, it has an almost edge-to-edge design, making it similar to iPhone's design. The V9 also has a metal body with a curved back. Both seem to sport the notch, much to some customers' dissatisfaction. Fortunately, the P20 Lite included an option to hide the notch. Fingerprints are a lot more noticeable on the P20 Lite compared to the Vivo V9 due to its glass black panel. However, this can be resolved by having a lighter colored version of the P20 Lite, either Client Blue or the Sakura Pink. As for its size, the Vivo V9 is larger than the P20 Lite. Surprisingly, the V9 weighs lighter than the P20 Lite. The placements of the fingerprint scanner and the camera are also the same on both smartphones. The fingerprint scanner is positioned at the back of the phone, which is honestly more favorable to me. The Vivo V9 with 6.3-inch IPS LCD screen has a larger display than the P20 Lite. When it comes to color reproduction, both phones seem to be doing well. You can view their screens at any angle and it won't change its color. Unfortunately, the Vivo V9 lacks on display brightness. Viewing it from a different angle makes it hard to see what's on the screen. As for the P20 Lite, the display can still be seen even if you're outdoors. Both phones seem to be proud of their camera capabilities. The Vivo V9's highlight feature is its 24MP front camera with 2.0 aperture. The two handsets also feature a dual rear camera setup with similar features including face detection, HDR, and panorama. We took some shots with the P20 Lite and the Vivo V9 to confirm the quality of their cameras. On the first sample shots, just looking at the sky makes it noticeable that the P20 Lite is brighter compared to the Vivo V9. The P20 Lite is sharp and the details are clear, which is similar to the Vivo V9 shot. The next sample shots were taken indoors. Once again, the P20 Lite is brighter than the Vivo V9's shot. However, the details in the V9 shot is sharper as compared to the P20 Lite. In this one, the Vivo V9 shot is dim, making it look a bit dull. The P20 Lite shot resembled real life more. We also made sure to take pictures outdoors when it was still bright. The P20 Lite shot is still brighter. Looking closer, the P20 Lite is more accurate as seen in the color of the leaves. On the Vivo V9, the leaves look darker and less vibrant than the P20 Lite shot. In these sample shots, the pictures were taken during nighttime. The colors on the P20 Lite shot looked vibrant as compared to the Vivo V9. However, both cameras produced sharp and clear images. The P20 Lite wins this round. As shown in the photo, the subject looks more vibrant and sharper in the P20 Lite shot. As for the Vivo V9, the subject looked a bit dull. Photos of subjects indoors were taken as well. The colors of the first shot popped out more than it does with the second shot. Let's move on to selfie shots. First, we took shots outdoors. The P20 Lite shot produced a more realistic shot since it included the subject's beauty marks. As for the Vivo V9, it made sure to put the focus on the subject and automatically smooth out her skin, going as far as removing her mole. In these shots, it would greatly depend on the person's preference. Once again, the Vivo V9 offers a beautified shot. In this case, the color is more accurate on the Vivo V9 shot. The P20 Lite made the subject's skin appear a bit orange. In this shot, you can see that the focus is purely on the subject in the V9's shot due to the blurred out background. When we took pictures with the main camera, the P20 Lite shots were brighter. Here, the Vivo V9 has a brighter image. The subjects look less haggard on the V9's shot, although the removal of the subject's beauty marks are a bit disconcerting. Overall, based on the photos that were taken above, the P20 Lite is perfect for taking photos outdoors as it produces a brighter image. As for the selfie shots, it will depend on the user if they would either want a more realistic photo or a beautified one. The P20 Lite is powered by a high-silicon Kirin 659 chipset with 4GB of RAM. it runs on Android 8.0 Oreo. Meanwhile, the Vivo V9 contains the Snapdragon 626 with 4GB of RAM that runs on Android 8.1 Oreo. The P20 Lite and the Vivo V9 both had a decent battery life. The P20 Lite is powered by a 3000 mAh battery and had 16 hours standby time. The device also had fast battery charging. Vivo V9 has a larger battery capacity of 3260 mAh and a standby time of 17 hours. In regards to their charging state, the P20 Lite took 1 hour and 45 minutes to charge and the Vivo V9 took 1 hour and 33 minutes. We also tested the two devices by playing the game PUBG. There weren't any problems with both of the phones and the gameplay was relatively smooth. However, both of the phones seemed to heat up slightly while in-game. Navigation inside the game was also easier on the P20 Lite. So, if you play a lot of games where you need to navigate a lot, you might want to choose the P20 Lite. Both of the phones also feature face unlock. Upon testing it, we found out that both won't open if the user's eyes are closed. This is useful since it means that the phone won't get unlocked when the user is asleep. However, the Vivo V9 face unlock doesn't work in the dark, unlike Huawei P20 Lite. In regards to its fingerprint scanner, the P20 Lite unlocks faster than the Vivo V9. We also made sure to watch movies on both devices. The two had great quality and the color was accurate, which made the movie watching experience worth it. Both devices produced a loud and clear sound at medium volume. Unfortunately, when the volume was maxed in the P20 Lite, the produced sound was a bit fuzzy and unclear. As for the Vivo V9, even when the volume was on max, the sound was still clear. The Vivo V9 is currently available in local stores for 17,990 pesos. All in all, both of the phones seem to have great specs for mid-range phones. Although, if the decision came to us, we would choose the P20 Lite. We believe that the P20 Lite is more worth its price. But remember, each phone has its own specialty and main features. The choice will still depend on you. The question is, which of the two do you favor more? Once again, this has been Daniel from Manila Shaker. Don't forget to press like if you liked the video and hit the subscribe button if you want to see more. Thank you for watching!